We have to address the hopes of the young for a brighter future, a future that secures the nation's productivity, prosperity, and freedom in a civil society that protects democracy and cherishes pluralism. His Majesty King Abdullah II. You are the voices of and for change. We have much to learn from you and from your participation in dialogue and the exchange of ideas. We gain strength from the aspirations and ideas of young generations. Her Majesty Queen Rania Al Abdullah. Jordan is a youthful society, and Jordanian youths are a priority area. In April 2000, UNICEF launched the Jordanian Adolescence Project, funded by the United Nations Foundation, with the primary objective of increasing life opportunities for adolescents, especially girls, through increased participation in society. The project ultimately aims at enabling youth to make critical life choices and engaging them in constructive, democratic dialogue, not only with their peers, but with their parents, teachers, and their community as well. By accomplishing this, youths become positive agents for change. The project's philosophy is simple. Through education and leisure activities, adolescents develop personal skills within the family and basic social skills at school, youth centers, and the community at large. 3 years into its planning and implementation, the project succeeded not only in promoting youth initiatives and addressing gender-specific issues, but also spreading awareness among family members and other stakeholders working with youths. As a first step towards achieving the project's objectives, the Princess Basma Youth Resource Center was contracted to conduct the training of several hundred youths in basic life skills and healthy lifestyles, so that youths would become trainers and facilitators upon their return to their local communities. Based on the premise that adolescents not only represent the future, but form also a big part of the present, adolescents must receive sufficient access to information, knowledge, skills, and networks to allow them to enjoy their rights, make effective life choices, and later achieve their full potentials as adults. Topics in basic life skills cover communication and negotiation skills, conflict resolution, assertiveness, creative thinking, stress management, dealing with diversities, accepting differences, and life planning. Healthy lifestyle topics cover smoking and substance abuse, promoting healthy habits and the psychological well-being of young people. In addition, facilitation skills and youth-led initiatives are covered, enabling youths to train other young people. Parallel to the training program conducted by Princess Basma Youth Resource Center, another component for national trainers and youth service providers was being implemented at the National Institute for Training. Institute trainers train thousands of their colleagues who are directly and indirectly working with young people and adolescent issues. The training modules used were especially developed for this project. Training modules, addressing service providers, focus on promoting a participatory, gender-sensitive approach to planning and managing adolescent programs and activities. Modules cover adolescence as a stage of life in addition to participation and how it relates to adolescent development. Modules also focus on participation through different settings of life, including family and school, as well as institutional life. Because the project aims to reach as many Jordanian youth as possible, strategic partnerships were built with several key institutions, such as the Higher Council for Youth and the Ministries of Education and Health, in addition to numerous civil society and non-governmental organizations. These partners were, in reality, the implementing arm of the project. Stakeholders were also involved to ensure the project's sustainability and longevity. Through newly acquired insight and experience acquired at forums, seminars, and workshops, parents, facilitators, and stakeholders are now able to better communicate with adolescents. To ensure the project's reliability and credibility, It was based on a national youth survey and a knowledge base developed jointly by the Department of Statistics and UNICEF. The data analysis will be used by government officials, legislators, and decision makers to spread awareness and formulate new policies pertaining to youth development in Jordan. The future plan is to build on the foundation and building blocks that have been established. By using a participatory approach and a sustainable and enabling environment, the project will have a multiplier effect and will reach many more young people throughout the country. The pioneering Jordanian Adolescence Project proved to be a great success and can be used as a model for youth development in the Middle East and the region.